This sunny and idyllic Mediterranean coast was the site of one of the world's greatest structures. It took a full 11 years to finish constructing the world's first aquapolis, the floating city of Terra Grigia. A sustainable metropolis operating on a massive solar energy matrix and equipped with the latest green technologies. Never before had solar energy been used to supply power to an entire city. But in 2004, Veltro, a terrorist group opposing the city's development, launched a bioterrorist attack. They not only released a virus, but also several creatures known as bioorganic weapons, further complicating the situation. This launched one of the worst tragedies the world has ever seen.
I believe.
The FBC, the world's leading counter-bioterror organization operating under the auspices of the US, was called in to direct efforts to contain the attack. The BSAA, a counter-bioterror NGO, which operates independently of the interests of any one country, went in as observers to assist the FBC. Realizing the need for immediate and decisive action, Supreme Local Headquarters issued the order to use the city's solar energy matrix on itself. Media outlets around the world began to refer to the incident as the Terra Grigia Panic. Following the incident, the FBC announced it has successfully disbanded the terrorist group called Veltro. It is now 2005, and a sense of calm and security is finally returning to the people. But, as you can see, the lost city of Terra Grigia remains inaccessible, a silent and potent symbol of the threat that bioterror poses for people around the world.
There you two are.
O'Brien, you don't normally join the fray.
Well, my doctor told me I need exercise. I assume you both know that the FBC has cordoned off the entire area. However, in the past few weeks, a number of mysterious carcasses have washed up.
I guess the FBC couldn't cover up a mess this big, huh?
Anyone who knows what happened here is gonna put two and two together.
And that's why I've sent the BSAA in to investigate. Did you pick up your new equipment from Quint?
The Genesis, something. Is that its name?
You didn't bother to read the manual, did you?
No, I brought it with me, just in case.
I hope you read quickly, because you're gonna need it on your mission.
Yeah, I'm on it.
All right, so I've been recording for like an hour and 20 minutes. Just turned off. Okay. This is part two right now, but I need to take a break, so.
Oh, I'll be back in 10.
Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Resident Evil Revelations. What was I going to say? Last episode was a bit of a taste of, like, it was a test, and it basically helped me gauge what this difficulty is going to mean. And I'm not stupid. Getting the shotgun isn't going to solve all my answers. However, it will make things easier. They have a bunch of health. So it's going to take more than one shot to kill them. That is obvious. However, what, you know, typically they just either give them more health or I do less damage. Either way, what doesn't change is the force. So the shotgun is still going to contain that same amount of impact that's going to blow them away. And that's going to help me be able to do more melee attacks, which I believe does a lot of damage. So getting a shotgun is going to help me out a lot. So I'm looking forward to that. But hopefully this episode isn't going to take me an extra hour and 20 minutes to record. Because that was ridiculous. Genesis, the nickname, a higher level bioscanner currently being tested and developed by the Global Pharmaceutical Consortium. It bounces special synchrotron, radiation off of a target in order to analyze it. Viral analysis. It is possible to detect and analyze even the smallest amount of viruses. Wow. Vaccine manufacturing. Since version 1.0.4, it has been possible to produce simple vaccines from the viral analysis data. Detection. Using synchrotron radiation, it is possible to detect specific objects. The data for bullets, medical herbs, etc. are registered within the internal memory of testing. If a detectable object is nearby, the indicator in the lower right area of the monitor will light up. I don't know how possible that is to be able to detect viruses, which I believe are like a hundredth the size of a cell. They are tiny as rule number one in gaming, always turn back.
What the hell are you doing?
Shh. What am I doing? Picking up this goddamn grenade. That is what I'm doing. Gaming 101. Okay, just making sure that door doesn't open. 10, 15, and I got that, which I believe is a secondary, which they said, like, press, and press another button. Maybe it's the R button, but I'm gonna test that out. Are you crazy? I'm gonna have tons of chances where I'm gonna die over and over and over and over and over again, where I'm going to be able to just give up and test a whole bunch of crap and see what the hell works out. That's what happened last episode. I just gave up on surviving and basically was like, well, I'm just gonna die over and over again, so, you know, might as well use this opportunity to see how things work out. And the dodging mechanic, by the way, doesn't always work. Like, it is an implementation for it to not always work. And something I realized was it always worked the first time I did it, but, like, so it works, and then you get hit, and then it works. So it's like, it's not exactly a 1 out of 3 chances, when it's just more of, you're gonna have to dodge 3 times. Like, you dodge once, it works, and then you're gonna wanna dodge twice after that, and it's not gonna work. I don't know what the reset is. Like,
skin so pale. I've never seen anything like it.
Use the Genesis to get a reading.
Yeah, I was about to say, I assume I have to use the Genesis. What is the gen? How do I? There you go. Okay. I'm like, let's figure out how to... Oh, that's right.
To get an accurate reading, scan the carcasses on the beach and send me your data.
Oh my god. That legitimately scared. What is it doing? Let's try this. Yeah, okay. I thought so. Now I'm gonna call you Barry number 2.
City. This must be a cakewalk.
I suppose. So why'd you quit the FBC for this outfit?
I wanted to be more involved.
I wanted to fight. I think this is like how you get health. I believe. Something else I was gonna say is like when I saw that cutscene, I was like getting flashback about the game. And whatever it is that I'm going to remember about the game, I will not spoil. Because the assumption is that, you know, some people are going to watch this that have never played the game before. And so I'm not going to say... something from inside it. Nope. Not yet. Yeah. So, you know, maybe somebody who's never played the game before is going to watch this, and so I'm not going to spoil anything. Which kind of sucks, because honestly, especially in you know, Resident Evil games, it's kind of very easy to spot out who the actual villain is and stuff like that. So, yeah, it's gonna suck because, like, I can't make, you know, my usual
Don't worry. I've done this before.
Predictions and stuff like that because I, from what I remember, I already know some stuff. Yeah, I wouldn't do that. I would not. Not after the thing we just fought.
I've got something.
Crazy.
What is this? If it's an engineered mutation, this could prove a link.
I'll run some tests on this. Continue with the investigation.
We're about to get all Metroid Prime up in here. Oh my god. I am... crazy when it comes to using this like using things like this just to make sure I don't miss anything, especially now because this is a very difficult setting that is going to just kick my ass left and right. Something's jamming it. Is this where I should have used the grenade? Because it looks like, look at the color difference between these two. Like it's not just, you know, a design saying, oh hey, there's something there, but we're never gonna find out what it is because you know it's locked forever.
That smell must have ruptured from gas.
Christ, what a mess.
Ooh, birdies. Really? I wanted more than handgun ammo. Okay. Next time something pops up, I'm gonna start backing away from it. Just so I can get a clear idea. Of the distance that I have to be to it. So that, you know. So I wouldn't have to, I guess this would be the distance, okay. And that's pretty good, it's about like the middle of the room. Middle of an average size room, I should say. Yeah, see. I back up and so, this is the distance that I have to be away from things for it to pick up. So I don't have to, you know, run to every corner. I can just get a good idea from a good distance. That's probably gonna be story, so let's pick this up. A green herb. Very helpful. First victim. Oh, is this a Okay, so that's like a... Speak. Well, what is it? Oh, it's just a block. Okay. Not an achievement, but a kind of side quest. Can't scan that, I assume. Is this where I'm supposed? No, it's not. This is dead end. However. Oh, I don't trust you. You're good to me. Thank you. Let's go. What else did I need? Oh, I knew it. I knew that was a thing. I got a pill. Pill is a green herb, I assume. Yep. Okay, so yeah. Whenever I get 100%. I get rewarded with a green herb, which is always welcome in my book. Now, is anybody going to come to life? Anybody? Going once? Going twice? The shack! I knew it. Oh, I knew it. Oh, you sack-a-tard. Ooh. Okay. I've been everywhere in this area, which means... Oh, he's dead. Okay.
Finally, some peace and quiet.
All in a day's work for you two, eh? All right, enough chit-chat. Get that sample data to me.
Sample right here.
Nice work.
No doubt about it. These corpses show signs of viral infection.
And I bet it's no coincidence they came through the FPC's blockade.
Well, we did all we can. Now, we wait for the results to come back from HQ. Huh? It's the emergency line. Yeah, it's me. Uh-huh. What? Yes, that's fine. I'll take it from here. We'll have to speed things up. Starting now. Uh-huh. Good. Get to it. Jill, Parker, you two are still on the case.
What happened?
We lost contact with Chris and Jessica.
When? How?
We're not certain. I've sent their last known coordinates to your terminals.
And that's how we arrived on the boat.
The signal was lost over the ocean. I thought they were in the mountains chasing Feltro. But judging from their position, they must be...
On a ship.
I believe that scanning... The enemies while they're alive grants you more percentage than scanning them while they're dead. And so, if I see myself at a good distance or like an object is between us, I'm gonna try and scan them while they're alive. And that's basically going to reward me with the health. It's the ammo conservation that I'm more worried about now. Because, God, 30 shots. 30 shots, you guys. What was... You're not gonna score me? For my, God. Hour and 20 minutes. I died so many times. It was... Oh, endless. Queens and Ovia.
These things got to Chris and Jessica?
I hope not.
Hey, no one's saying Chris is dead.
All right. I haven't seen that.
Let's find him already.
Theory number two, are you gonna turn on me?
You hear that? Was that the lock?
I'll check it out.
So wait, what about my health?
Okay.
Did you not keep the herbs, woman?
I'll see what I can find here.
Copy that. I'll radio Harumph. Chris's trail.
Alright, well, let's...
This thing has a lot of similarities to the corpses on the beach.
Oh, that's dang. Okay. There you go. No, it's just the, that guy, right?
Yeah.
Just see if there's anything else. No. Nothing in the splotch. Nothing in the gobbledygook. Okay. Then, I was about to say, why is that thing still blinking though? Okay, awesome. This map needs to, like, fix itself before it wrecks itself. Okay. Whatever. Whatever! God! Map sucks! Ass! Ass jets! But I was gonna do this though. Item found. Ha! Ah. Suckers! Woo-woo-woo-woo. Was there anything here? Nothing else in this room. Okay. The bottom right corner would light up if there was anything else in the room. There's no point. So there's nothing in this room except for like enemies, but ain't nobody here. I ain't seeing shit! Okay, so I'm going downstairs. Now, if I were a safe place, where would I be? I would be there.
Chris!
Damn it.
Come on, oh, say no. Something!
Oh no, turn around, girl. Turn around!
But he's trapped in there.
Can you get him out?
No, it's a tough lock.
Move.
I need the key.
Okay, then let's find it.
Okay. I thought maybe, you know. Can I, like... Okay, I thought maybe I can search the thing. The thing of the thing. Okay. Music. Still other items. However, the music is wrong. And I have declareth. That's a lot of shotgun shells. Say what you want. That is a lot of shotgun shells. Here. Does it matter where I'm looking? No. It matters about the position. Okay, so it's the room next to me. So it's not necessarily the entire room, it's just how close you are to said object. Okay. That is also important to note. Give me more. I don't know what the thing is. Nor do I trust it. Do I shoot? Guys! Okay. Well. That did the least spot. So. Gun for it. Wow, magnum ammo. Already. Oh, that's the other thing they've already. Oh hell nah. I don't have enough ammo. This is not enough ammo. Oh, I just got bitch slapped. Oh no. Okay. I can do this. That's one. Now, turn the other way around. Come on. Show me that pretty face of yours. Not that face. I need to pay attention to when they save. Oh, really? Another way of dodging is when you do the turnaround. Oh, come on! Okay. Whatever. Until I get my shotgun, I'm not. What the hell? Whatever. Until I get my shotgun, I cannot risk fighting anybody. Oh, that's. Familiar! Why do I see that and just feel. Safe. Why? Why do I feel internal safety from it? Could I be wrong? To feel safe? And this map is not accurate whatsoever. Frickin' hell. All right, well, I think I'm going to end this episode right here. I'll record one more and see how far I can get. I really wish that room was just open. Just let me in. I need to reach some form of save point. So, can I save? Is there anything I can save? Yeah, okay. I didn't think so. So, until the next time we meet, this is your Middle Eastern geek and nerd. Peacing out.